Hi friends, welcome back to the Pragmatic Lopa. As you all know, before I did a DIY on yarn lanterns, if you haven't seen it and you wish to see, the link will be provided in the description box. Anyways, in today's DIY, we'll use the same yarn orbs, but the purpose is entirely different. Once you are done with your fairy light yarn lantern decor, you can either simply reuse some of these colorful yarn orbs, else just make few orbs of different sizes and of your preferred color as vase fillers, or use in a bowl as an attractive centerpiece and use them as you like. And if it's your first time and you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. So without further ado, let's start with the process. For this, you can use any size of balloons you want. I wanted mine to be as small as possible, so got these water balloons, inflated them, but not too much, and secured with a knot. And you will need any vase or bowl which you wanna use as a centerpiece. And if you like, for extra lighting, you can use string lights, which is optional. Use any color of yarn or wool you like, and you'll need equal parts of regular all-purpose glue, hot water, cornstarch, and a mixing bowl. Start with cornstarch. Now add hot water and start mixing them well with a spoon as soon as possible to avoid formation of lumps. You can do this DIY even without cornstarch with just glue and water, but I strongly recommend to add cornstarch, which would thicken the glue and the yarn is much more firm and strong. You can see for yourself towards the end. Now to this, add equal part of glue and mix the solution well. Make sure you protect the surface you're working on. You can directly soak the yarn in the solution and use it to wrap the balloons. But trust me, it's so damn messy and lot more time consuming. So I recommend you to use any regular carton available in kitchen or a paper cup. I cut open this big milk carton using X-Acto knife and poke it with a needle threaded with yarn across the bottom of the carton as low as possible. Once you pull the yarn from the other end, pour in the solution mix into it. So when the yarn passes through this glue mix, it soaks up the glue, and when pulled through the hole you created, the excess glue is removed automatically, leaving only the adequate amount of glue required. And also by this process, you can manage yarn easily without getting tangled, hence avoids getting messier. Make a knot with yarn at top of the balloon. At this point, leave some amount of yarn before making the knot, which would be later used for drying to hang these balloons. But as I forgot to leave extra length of yarn, I'll use separate piece of twine to hang them to dry later. Start wrapping the balloon randomly. Keep in mind, don't wrap the yarn too tight, else it might slip off, but not too loose as well. Just tight enough to fit the balloon. Just work it out couple of times here and there till you feel it's stable. Keep wrapping as much as you want. I did wrap for almost 60 to 70% of the balloon. Once you're happy with how you want it to look, cut it with scissors and slide in the end of the yarn underneath. As I mentioned before, I used a separate piece of twine for individual balloons. Now either you can tie a string across two chairs and hang the balloons to dry, but I just hang them across the wall using thumbtacks. Usually it takes 4 to 5 hours to dry, but for safer side, I left it overnight. Once they're all dried up, you can see and hear too. They're so tight and sturdy. Now pierce the balloon with any pokey object. It deflates instantly, creating this weird noise. Now just simply pull out the deflated balloon and you'll have your first yarn orb. At times while deflating, the balloon may get stuck. You can use any pointy object like tweezer or scissors to help it pull with ease. Make these yarn orbs of different sizes for a better look. Once you have all the yarn orbs ready, fill in the bowl or use as jar fillers. And as I mentioned before, if you wish, you can add an extra visual effect by inserting these string lights into these yarn orbs. Once you're done with inserting lights into all the orbs you require and filling the vase or bowl the same way as I showed you before, and enjoy your cheerful mornings and lively evening. Hope you liked it, and if you have, please hit that like button and also subscribe to my channel. Let me know in the comment section below. If you got any requests or suggestions, if you wish, you can follow me on social media. The links will be in the description box below. Thanks for stopping by. Until next time, take care. See you guys soon.